Hey student, this is lecture 1 for structure analysis for GATE and ESC preparation. In the first lecture, basic lecture, we will see the different methods for structure analysis. So first thing is, what is structure? So structure is the combination of members, joints, supports to carry different loads. So what is structure? Structure is the main combination of members, joint and support. So in basic lecture, we will go through some type of members, then type of joints and type of support with different type of loads that structure can carry. After that, we will go to the analysis part. In analysis part, first we will go to the axial force diagram, shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. After that, we will analyze slope and deflection of different structure using method, moment area method, conjugate beam method, unit load method and double integration method. One thing I can tell you, for GATE and other exams, conjugate beam method and unit load method are more important than moment area method and double integration method. Most of the problem can be very easily can be solved with conjugate beam method and for frame unit load method. After calculating slope and deflection, we will go to the indeterminate structure. Then finally, we will see the matrix method. So one by one, in 50 to 60 lecture, we will complete whole structure analysis. For structure analysis, I will recommend you two books. That one is R.C. Hibbler by Pearson Publication, and another is C.K. Wang by McGraw-Hill Publication. These two are the more than sufficient books for structure analysis. You will get whole theory for structure analysis. So now we can go through the classification of structure. What is the classification of structures? And I have told you that structure is the combination of members. So classification of structure is depend on classification of members. So we will go through the classification of members. So first member is the truss member. Or we can also say that tie member. This is a truss member or tie member. Truss member is basically a rod which is either in tension or in compression. Here in this, we have either in tension or compression. There is no shear force and bending moment diagram, bending moment in truss member. So these can be always chosen a circular section, a square section, an angle section, or sometime we can say a channel section, C or I. But most preferable sections are circular section, square section and angle section. So again, repeating, truss member contain only tension and compression. There is no shear force, there is no bending in truss members. The second member is our beam member. Second structure member is the beams member. This is very important member. Beam member contain shear and bending both. Normally beam we cannot design for axial force. Sometimes axial force is also there in beam, but design of beam is basically for shear and bending. Normally we can't design it for axial force. So beam member, a simple beam member carry vertical load, or we can say a transverse load. Beam carry vertical or transverse load. It can carry axial load, but we can't design it beam for axial load because axial loads are negligible than transverse or vertical loads. So for long beam are designed for bending movement. Long beams are designed for bending movement, while short beams with large load are designed for shear force also. So normally in beam we can design bending movement and shear force. Other than this, the classification of beams is depend on classification of beams. This depend on type of supports. As we can say, this is a fixed end and free end. This is, we can say, cantilever beam. If both ends are simply supported, then we can say simply supported beam. If one end is fixed, other end is simply supported, then we can say prop cantilever beam. This end is prop end. If there are more than two supports, then we can say this is a continuous beam. If beam is overhang from one end, free end, then we can say this is overhang beam. So basically classification of beams is depend upon the type of suppose we use. So this is the beam member. Second, after that, the third member is used for different structure is our column member. As like in trusses, we have truss used for axial force only in tension and compression. Similarly, Column members are basically used for compression loads. So if this is a column, then we have compressive load from both sides. But sometimes columns are joined with beam, just like in a frame structure. So these are attached with beam. So these columns are denoted as beam column. Beam column if attached to a beam. Then beam columns are designed for both compression and bending. Compression and bending. There are different columns also depend upon the type of support. As we can say, this is a fixed end column. Then we have fixed simply support column. Then we have fixed free, simply support column. In column chapter, we will analyze all these type of different columns. So again, column member is basically designed for compressive loads. And if columns are attached with beam, then these are known as beam column and designed for both compressive loads and bending. Now with combination of all these members, whether it is a column member or a truss member or a beam member, we can draw different type of structure. So different classification of structure we will go through the it. So our first in classification of structure is trusses. Very important. In trusses, like this is a truss. So one thing you note down that in trusses, all the joints are pin joint. All joints are pin joint. All members are tie members, or we can say truss members. Therefore, contain either tension denoted by T or compression denoted by C. The notation of tension and compression is like this. This is tension and this is compression. There is little confused notation for this. It is showing that both the arrow are consigned at a point. So this we can say that this is not a tension, this is a compression and this is a tension. But this tension is, this arrow is not for this point. This arrow is for these joints. Let's assume that these are the A and B joint. If you break this joint, then it will be like this. T and T. That is, the tension T is pulling joint B and also pulling joint A. Similarly, if there is a joint A and B, now if we do draw, then it will like this. So now you can say that at joint A, this C give compression. Similarly, at joint B, C give compression. So this is the symbol for tension and compression. So at every joint, these all joint, whether internal joints or support joints, all joints are pin joints and all members are tie members. So all members, either they will be in tension or compression, but as a whole structure, this structure bend like this. So at the upper member, we will get compression. At the upper member, we will get compression, while at the lower members we will get tension. Other members can be tensile or compressive depending upon the load. The advantage of truss over the beam is that it uses less material. Advantage of truss over beam, that it uses less material for a given load. And mostly truss is constructed for long span. So for long span, truss structure is the best structure, while for short span, we can construct beams. Other is that all members are in tension or compression and they are cylinder as tie member. So their construction is also very easy and can be constructed in any shape and can be constructed in any shape. So if depth is not a consideration, if depth is not a consideration, then mostly we use truss structure. So the beam structure we can use for cross section with I member. As in beam, we use I section. So for I section, the flanges, top and bottom flanges, designed to resist movement. Top and bottom flanges designed to resist movement. While web designed to resist shear. So while in truss, all members are designed for tension or compression. So analysis for trusses is also simple and construction is also very simple than beams and other members. While for reinforced concrete, if the beam is of this beam, I section normally we use for aluminium or steel. If instead of aluminium or steel, we use reinforced concrete members, pre-stress, post-stress, or so normal reinforced, then we use rectangular section. Then we can use rectangular section because construction of rectangular section is easy than I section and channel section. So other than beam structure and truss structure, there is third variety of structure. We can say that these are cables. It's a joint. And this is, we can say this is a cable. So cable is designed only for tension. So in cable there is only tension, there is no compression, there is only tension. Another is carry only vertical load. It carry only vertical load. There is no horizontal load on the cables. So cables carry only vertical load, designed only for tension. The advantage of cables over truss and beams are that they are flexible, less construction and material cost. But where there is a wind, high speed wind, we can't prefer cable structure or because wind is disturb the flexible structure. So at those places we can construct only truss structure or beam structure. So again I am repeating this, it carry only tension. There is no shear, no bending in the cables member. Other than cables, the just opposite of cables is, we can say, the next structure, that arches. Arches are like this. It's cables are sagged downward and arches are topward. The only difference between cables and arches is cables are flexible while arches are rigid. Cable carry only tension while arches carry only compression. So there is only compression in the arches, and arches are the rigid structure while cables are the flexible structure. So arch carry both shear and bending. So cables designed only for tension and which depend on sag, while arches designed for shear and bending both. Arches designed for shear and bending both. After arches, the final and the most important structure is the frame structure. Most of the buildings are designed with a frame structures. Frames. Like this is a simple example of frames. This is an example of frame. This we can say these are beam. This is column. This is also column. Since column is attached with beam, so we can say these are beam column structure. So designed both for bending and compression. And this joint is a rigid support. So we can say fixed support. And this is a pin support. Similarly, this is a pin joint. And this is a rigid joint. At pin joint, there is no bending. At pin joint, there is no bend. That movement is equal to zero. While at rigid joint, we have shear, axial force, shear force, and bending movement, all the three. So the structure, most of the frame structure are designed with beam column joint, that is a rigid joint. Depend upon the different structure, different type of frame, we can draw different type of structure. So this is overall basics of structure analysis. In the next class, we will go through the type of loads and type of support, then their determinancy, indeterminacy, and other things. Thank you.